out of the shadows of a much darker London than the one we have now. It wasn't a pedestrian on a street, there wasn't alfresco restaurants. It was a poorer London, a less glamorous London, and one really still in the shadow of the Second World War, and I think that was the context that Ziggy appeared in. He was the ultimate messianic rock star. With him, Bowie successfully blurred the lines, not just between boys and girls, but between himself and his creation. You know, Bowie was Ziggy come to save us, and I bought him hook, eyeliner, and haircut. Looking back to what we can now safely call the golden age of rock, this was a cultural high point of some significance. The album not only changed David Bowie's life forever, but it changed mine in a generation of adolescents who were trying to find an escape from the ennui of existence and the hard times of the early 70s. And as a teenager, I'd visit this stream, you know, I'd go to the telephone box, convinced that he was transported into it. You know, I had to phone someone, so I picked on you, and he picked on me. And wonder about the significance of the Kanye West sign. Quest, of course it was, you know, it all made sense back then. But I now believe that Ziggy is one of London's great fictional characters and stands alongside the likes of Dorian Gray, the Artful Dodger, and great anti-heroes like Steerpipe, or even, and obviously, A Clockwork Orange's Alex. Can I say, it seems right that the job of doing this, and it is an honour, I can't tell you what an honour, should go to a fanboy. After all, you know, Ziggy is no longer with us. He was killed off by his creator in 1973. And what of that creator? Well, he's currently nurturing his well-earned enigma in New York. In any case, as Ziggy once sang, he'd like to come and meet us, but he thinks he'll blow our minds, and I'm sure he would if he was here. Before I unveil this, I just want to say how amazing it is to have two of the spiders here, Trevor Boulder and Woody Woodmansey. Yay. David at that time had mousy brown hair, and Terry chose to paint it bright blonde, which I think added some sort of otherworldliness of it, and to highlight the Kanye West sign, but it made it look like some sort of film set from a film noir movie, and I think that was very significant. And also, I'd like to mention Absent Heroes. Ziggy's great lieutenant, to me, the greatest guitarist that ever lived. Who rode shotgun throughout the entire album, Mick Ronson. And finally, a mention to Freddie Beretti, who was this beautiful young boy, who nearly was Ziggy Stardust, in fact, who designed and stitched together all that material that Angie bought in Liberties. And really, you know, based on some sort of nostalgia for the future, created the look that I still hold up as being the greatest one ever in rock music. So finally, I should do this really, shouldn't I? So we'll never forget where Ziggy first landed.